Chickens raised for meat are among the most abused animals on the planet. Animal Equality has documented this abuse for years, which can be clearly seen through our latest investigatory work. This is how 90% of chickens used for meat live. In the U.S., approximately 450 million baby chickens died on farms in 2019 before reaching the slaughterhouse, due in large part to the absence of the most basic welfare conditions. These baby birds have been genetically selected for years to grow as fast as possible. Today, their growth rate is 6 times higher than it was 90 years ago. They are sent to the slaughterhouse at about 42 days old, an age at which they have not yet reached sexual maturity. Their life is governed by 2 conditions, intense overcrowding and the limitations that prevent them from supporting their own bodies. The law allows for such high stocking densities of these birds that sometimes they have less space than they would if they were in a cage. It is practically impossible for them to walk or even stretch their wings. Genetic selection for rapid and extreme growth is responsible for the greatest number of welfare problems for baby chickens associated with their breed. Their bodies become their own cages. 1/4 of all chickens suffer from deformities and immobility. This genetic selection for hurried growth generates numerous disorders such as ascites, a disorder causing the baby chickens to accumulate fluid in their abdomens, causing pain and preventing them from moving. The trough lines are adjustable, rising as the baby chickens grow, but they should never be above the chicken's chest. Sadly, the smallest ones and those with mobility problems often cannot reach them and will end up dying a slow death due to hunger and/or thirst. Other metabolic diseases they suffer from are sudden death syndrome and pectoral muscle necrosis. Typically, the same litter is used for 6 flocks, meaning the same litter is used for 1 year. When litter is not properly cleaned, ammonia produced by the baby bird's feces and urine leads to breathing issues and stinging of the eyes. And, since many of the birds are too heavy to lift themselves off the ground, the ammonia-laden litter burns the birds, causing painful boils. These wounds are the entry points for bacterial infections. 20% of baby chickens suffer from them. After 6 weeks of living in these bare and filthy conditions, the baby birds reach the growth that the industry considers optimal and are sent to the slaughterhouse. The most commonly used method to stun them is to hang them upside down by their legs and submerge their heads in electrified water. However, many miss the water and thus are fully conscious as the kill blade slits their throat. In Animal Equality's corporate outreach department, we work to improve the lives of chickens raised for meat. Our goal is to reduce the suffering of these baby birds by working cooperatively with companies to adopt a meaningful chicken welfare policy. All major animal protection groups in North America agreed on a set of welfare criteria to be met by companies operating in the U.S., coined the Better Chicken Commitment. This agreement states that the maximum stocking density is 6 pounds per square foot and disallows cages. The allowed breeds have demonstrably better welfare results, and their barns meet minimum standards in terms of light, litter, and air quality. Controlled atmospheric processing is used as the slaughter method, and, finally, that compliance with these standards is assured through third-party audits. Hundreds of major companies have already adopted these welfare criteria, including IKEA, Unilever, Sodexo, Chipotle, Nestle, Compass, Popeyes, Burger King, and Papa John's. Consumers are becoming increasingly concerned about animal welfare. Ketchum, a global public relations firm, recently released a study that found animal welfare was the top concern for Americans. They ranked animal welfare above children's education and hunger. The lifetime of suffering these baby birds face is no life at all.